All the Jewish and black members, can we come on down, please?
It's a rousing start. It's a rousing start.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Where are the Jews? Come on, where are the blacks?
In fact, I'm going to get back to the camera.
Ben, Abby, let's go.
Napoleon.
Madsen.
Dave.
And, you know, intermingle, like,
don't just not all
black. Black,
no.
You black, no.
Yes. Hopefully we have enough to do that.
This is hilarious. You should have coordinated this better.
Yes.
You can't be black.
These are mics. Y'all can't say it. Somebody's
just going to be ridiculous.
Remember, never behind the podium.
Yeah, we need a couple. We need someone over here. Yes. If you want to come up here.
This is the first time I've stood up here.
Oh, is that right?
Ready? Good morning, everybody. My name is. Oh. Are we ready? Good morning, everybody. My name is Jared Solomon. I am a state representative in Northeast Philadelphia, 202nd Legislative District. And we are here to announce the formation of the Black-Jewish Caucus. To announce the formation of the Black-Jewish Caucus.
Yay!
Much better. Much better. Oh, here she comes. Here she comes. So why are we here? Why is this important? When I was in high school, I took part in a group called Operation Understanding. Operation Understanding, six black students from Philadelphia, six Jewish students from Philadelphia, coming together to explore the historic relationship between blacks and Jews. Then we all went on a trip to Senegal and Israel to further that relationship. And finally, we would come back and speak at senior centers and mosques and synagogues and churches about what we learned. When I was reflecting on that relationship and how positive that impact was in my life, I thought about a few things. First of all, the relationships that I built, the friendships that I built, I've maintained those friendships to today. And not only have I maintained the friendships, but on key issues in my life, both personal and also key issues that I care about, social justice issues. That group of six black students and six Jewish students now today come together on those issues in sort of a united front. We've maintained those friendships. So what Jordan and I thought is, imagine if in this institution, we could build those relationships, further those relationships, and then as Jewish and black legislators, use those relationships to do really good things. Now, I wanted to comment on the good things part, because every time we talk about the black-Jewish relationship, we seem stuck in many years ago, decades ago. So sort of the magic happened in this relationship during the civil rights movement. And when we think about it, this is the high water mark where blacks and Jews came together in this historic effort. They helped form the NAACP. They helped pass key milestone civil rights legislation, the Voting Rights Act. They helped together on housing legislation. But then what? And every time Jordan and I have talked about it, the then what seems lacking. You always go back to that high water mark. And of course, that is a foundation of a relationship, but any good relationship always needs to be renewed and revitalized and reworked to take on the challenges of today. And that's what we are here to do. So I am thrilled to help kick off this caucus. And now I want to turn it over to the co-chair, my good friend, Representative Jordan Harris.
All right. So good morning. I'm State Representative Jordan Harris. I serve my neighbors in South and Southwest Philadelphia in the neighborhoods of Point Breeze, Grays Ferry Graduate Hospital, and King Sessing. in the 186th Legislative District. And I'm so glad to be joined by several of my colleagues who I'll introduce. Representative Napoleon Nelson, Representative Regina Young, Representative Dan Frankel. You've heard from Representative Solomon, Representative Ben Waxman, Representative Chris Rabb, Representative Abigail Salisbury, Representative Justin Flemings, Representative Dave Madsen, and Representative Darisha Parker, and we have supporters here as well. I concur with a lot of what my colleague, Representative Solomon, said, and he is a friend as well, and we've been talking and toying with this idea of the Black and Jewish Caucus, understanding that our history as Blacks in this country and Jewish Americans in this country have had a past of supporting one another. And yet, in our present, a lot of times, we have not necessarily renewed that support as we should have. Understanding that, you know, being stronger together is not just a slogan, but in this building is actually a reality. When it comes to counting votes and it comes to getting things done, we are honestly stronger together. In addition to that, the formation of this caucus is really not about symbolism. And I was very clear when Representative Solomon and I and some of the advocates talked. Symbolism is good and it's nice, but the people of Pennsylvania need substance. Amen. And the truth is that this caucus is about really having the tough conversations that are necessary. In families, we have disagreements. In families, we have squabbles. But we remember that we are in it together. And this family of Pennsylvanians, this collection of legislators that you see behind me, that, you know, for me is the goal, is for us to have the tough conversations that are necessary, but look at ways that we can work together and while working together, get things done for the people of the Commonwealth. So this is just another opportunity for us to share our commonalities and not allow those things that may show us different and keep us apart, but the commonalities and the cords that bind us together. How can we use those for the purpose of benefiting the people of Pennsylvania? So I'm glad to be here and to be working with my colleague, Representative Solomon, on this endeavor in hopes that from this come the tough conversations that need to be had, come the disagreements. But out of those tough conversations and disagreements come the majesty of solidarity. The majesty of solidarity. Why? Because when anti-Semitism happens, we should speak up. But when Black bodies drop in the city of Philadelphia and across this Commonwealth, we should also speak up. So it is our collectivism and our collective voice that strengthens us as a community. So we're grateful for all of those. I will make mention we've now been joined by the representative from Montgomery County, Representative Greg Scott. And with that, I'll turn it back over to my colleague, Representative Solomon.
Thank you, Representative Harris.
Sure.
Representative Frankel's eager. Say a few words.
I just want to say how grateful I am to Representative Harris and Representative Solomon for doing this. Before I came into the legislature, I was the chair of the Community Relations Council of the United Jewish Federation in Pittsburgh. And during that time, we established a Black-Jewish dialogue that is ongoing until this day, and I think there's probably something very similar in Philadelphia as well, to try and bridge a common history in many ways and some of the tensions that exist between our communities. But we know, as Jared talked about earlier, the rich history of Blacks and Jews working together, particularly in the Civil Rights Movement. And the first thing that came to my mind was the Freedom Rider summer in 1964, when three young people, an African-American and two Jews, James Chaney, Andrew Goodman, and Michael Schwerner, were murdered. during that Freedom Ride summer. A horrendous incident, but also something I think that illustrated the kind of the ties that we have as communities, some of the common history in terms of persecution, discrimination, and sometimes some of the tension that exists. But to try and bring us together, particularly as legislators, to be effective, to drive home an agenda, particularly with respect to social justice, and collaborate in the way we should be to represent our communities, the great histories that we have, and also the vulnerabilities, is really something that I think is worthy of putting this caucus together. So congratulating them, looking forward to working with them to further mutual understanding and a common agenda to help transform our Commonwealth. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Franco. Anyone else want to say a few words? Representative Rapp. Come on.
Good morning. I'm State Representative Chris Rabb from Northwest Philadelphia, covering Chestnut Hill, Mount Airy, West Oak Lane, and Bluebell Hill. My experience growing up was with blacks and Jews. In fact, I thought all white people were Jewish. And I met a white Christian. I'm like, that's great. They can have white Christians, too. I grew up blacks and Jews. My father desegregated University of Louisville in the 50s. And the only people who would embrace him were his Jewish fellow medical students, and he learned Yiddish. I thought that was normal at home. My district has a very vibrant, diverse Jewish population that I'm very proud of, committed to social justice, inclusion, and I think this is a beautiful thing that's happening. There are prevailing narratives that we don't get along and that there should be some ongoing tension that cannot be resolved. I dispute that. And most recently, when I was at my mosque in my district after a hate crime, who was there? Jewish leaders, Christian leaders. And it's interesting because the mosque used to be a church. You know what it was before church, Jared? It was a synagogue in West Oak Lane. Our histories are interwoven, and our futures. In addition to embracing our cultural identity and our practices and the things we care about, our values, we also have to come together to indeed fight white supremacy. We have to fight white supremacy because we are all victims of that. And not just blacks and Jews, everyone is a victim when that is instilled in our society. So I'm really honored to be here, and I thank Representatives Solomon and Harris for making this happen. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Now, David, did you want to say a few words? David Edmund, please, come on up. Thanks.
Okay. Good morning. My name is David Edmund. It's a pleasure to be here. I want to thank Representatives Solomon and Harris for bringing this group together, for their words this morning, which were right on point and very meaningful. I wanted to introduce two people who have just come into the room. They are Rabbis Deborah and Earl Bowen. They are the spiritual leaders of Congregation Temple Bethel, a predominantly African-American synagogue in the West Oak Lane section of Philadelphia. About 4.5 years ago, Rabbi Earl Bowen approached me and said, you know, remember that program, Operation Understanding? As great as it was, and it was a terrific program, for various reasons, it lost momentum, lost its funding, and is now defunct. And Rabbi Bowen said to me, why don't we try to bring back Operation Understanding? So it was on that premise that we started meeting, mostly in the conference room at Temple Bethel, brought a few people together. It was late 2018, because I believe that our representatives, Solomon and Harris, attended Shabbat services at Temple Beth El in November or December of that year. Unfortunately, COVID hit in early 2019, which slowed us down, but it didn't stop us. And we formed an organization called the Alliance of Trust. We're incorporated. We have 501c3 nonprofit status. And the sole purpose of the Alliance of Trust is to bring together blacks and Jews to combat racism and anti-Semitism. So we are thrilled to have reached this milestone today. With the help of our friends behind me, and hope to encourage all of you, more people, to get involved. Our website is alliance of trust.org, and we've done interesting programs on the role of sports in combating racism and anti-Semitism, building programs to teach the history of the relationship between blacks and Jews, and most importantly is something we call conversations, to try to create smaller groups of people who will commit to coming together regularly, could be quarterly, every other month, but not anything but one and done. And the purpose is to build relationships, build trust, build friendship, and build a sense of community.
Thank you, David. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Next up, Representative Derisha Parker, please.
I know. Good morning. My name is State Rep. Derisha Parker, representing Logan, Nicetown, East and West Oak Lane, Alleyne, and Germantown. It's actually an honor and exciting to be here because one of the first person I spoke to today is an alum of Operation Understanding, is my brother, who's my political director. So it's an honor to be here, and I'm actually looking forward to making sure organizations like yours, when you mentioned West Oak Lane, making sure that there's funding opportunities that individuals that rep West Oak Lane look to know that there is a conversation that needs to be had beyond a cell phone. That needs to mean that we go back when we're breaking bread together and talking about our faith and sharing different ideas, even if we politically don't align, but we have to come back together as a family to educate the masses of what is happening. I've been saying all along that we are definitely in a spiritual warfare. Today has given me some hope and renewal in my faith and other things that we need to be doing collectively together as a family. So I thank you, and it's an honor to be here, and it's an honor to look forward to work and align with this caucus to make sure we bring spiritual harmony in not just body of government, but in this commonwealth and amongst each other by saying thank you and have a blessed day.
Thank you. Do you guys have any questions?
Yeah. We heard a lot about conversations. In terms of action, and I know Representative Harris said that you want to take action, not just about symbolism and talk and so forth. Just wondering, in terms of what this caucus can do to back each other's priorities. When I look up there, I see people who, broadly speaking, are politically aligned, but we all know that most ideas in Pennsylvania, most bills that are drafted never become law.
You're saying because we're all Democrats?
So what can you do as a caucus legislatively to really have each other's backs in terms of saying, I'm going to fight for that bill, that's your priority, and you're going to fight for this bill, it's my priority?
I think that legislative priorities, legislative victories begin with relationship building. And that's what we need to do. So if you look back, you know, Representative Frankel talked about it, right? The historical legacy of this relationship needs to be reignited. So by the way, though, if we get back to that legacy and collectively always call out the scourge of anti-Semitism and bigotry and racism, together, collectively, that's a pretty good start. And then using that relationship to go on to bigger, grander victories. Anyone else want to comment on that?
Yeah, I'll say something.
Please.
So, just to offer sort of a tangible example of something, there are security grants available from the administration that kind of partially came about after the Tree of Life shooting, right? And they're designed to protect people who are facing different kinds of threats, but like right-wing extremism. And so certainly there are many Jewish-led organizations that have gone through the process of applying for these security grants to get them. There are many Black-led organizations that are also the target of the same kind of right-wing extremism, right? So that's an example, and I know that there are people in that community who have applied for these similar grants. So that's just an example of a current program that I know a lot of people in our community are utilizing, that we may be able to work together to find other, you know, communities that need to be protected in the same way that the Jewish community, unfortunately, has had to be. So thank you.
That's a great point. Representative Frankel, too.
So there is one legislative initiative that is that I expect to at least get moving in the legislature, and it is an example of collaboration between a Black member of our caucus and myself as a Jewish member. Napoleon Nelson and I have a package of hate crime bills to update Pennsylvania's hate crime statute that hasn't been addressed in over 40 years. To address the epidemic of not only anti-Semitism, but of racism, of bigotry, of homophobia across the state. I hope, my guess is most of these folks are co-sponsors of those bills, but I think here's an example of collaborating with an agenda that I think will be help transform the Commonwealth and turn us away from the hatred, anti-Semitism, and racism that we see kind of like taking over and becoming normalized. We want to be, I think, a bulwark against the normalization of those awful trends. So, thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else want to weigh in on that? Just to add, we did extend the invitation to Republican members, Jewish members. There were scheduling issues, so we hope to build out that coalition. I think I know most of the Jewish members on the Republican side, but I'm not.
Okay, so they may be joined. Do you have any sense of whether they're joining?
There was certainly interest, so we'll follow up. And as we have our internal meetings, they'll be invited.
Fantastic. Since I can hog this, because I don't actually see anybody else on that.
I think you're the only game in town.
Yeah, exactly.
Do you want to come up and speak?
Yeah. Are you Jewish? You can join the caucus.
There's just one detail. I'm just black. Get 65,000 people to vote for me. In terms of what each, I think somebody alluded to that there have been times when there have been, you know, not every member of each community has been supportive of both communities. Is there more of a role for leaders within each community to play in terms of shouting down people within their own community who compromise relationships? You know, in terms of Black leaders saying things to Black people who might harbor anti-Semitic beliefs, and in terms of Jewish leaders saying things to any Jewish people who might harbor any racist beliefs.
I think any good relationship is built on honest admission on when you have disagreement. And there have been disagreements between the Black and Jewish community on key issues, but the key is, can we come together, can we find ways to work in a collaborative way?
Does anyone else want to weigh in on that?
Yeah,
go ahead, Chris.
There's a prevailing narrative that, and I referenced this briefly earlier, about a simmering tensions between Blacks and Jews, but I think corporate media has much to do with that. So it's not a question that is often brought up with white Gentiles and Jewish people. It's often centered around the behaviors and thoughts of Black people as it relates to Jewish people, and perhaps to some extent vice versa. I hope as a caucus we can push back against those prevailing narratives, because I don't believe there's a lot of there. While there are tensions within all communities and between all communities, that prevailing narrative is problematic. And I hope that we as a caucus would really focus on the facts and the opportunities.
Thanks, Rep. Anyone else? Thank you all.
Thank you so much.